New rebates and tax credits are making it easier for San Diego residents to use solar energy to heat the water in their homes. But is a solar water heater worth the cost? The industry thinks so. KPBS reporter Sharon Heilbrunn has the story.
Solar water heaters might be more affordable now that state regulators recently approved $350 million in rebates for homes and businesses that switch to solar water heating. Katrina Pruksukarn of the California Center for Sustainable Energy says this is a boost to the industry.
This is very exciting. It's something that's been much anticipated by the industry, not only the California Center for Sustainable Energy, but also for solar water heating installers and solar water heating manufacturers. And then, of course, like you said, folks who are looking to maybe install this type of technology, this is going to be hopefully the financial push or kick that will help them be able to afford these systems. So it's definitely going to be something that will make it more cost effective. An average solar water heating system should offset about 75% of the energy that is currently used to heat your water.
Well, how exactly does a solar water heater work?
So a lot of people think that a solar water heating system replaces your current conventional fuel water heating system, and actually it works in conjunction with whatever water heater that you currently have. This is the most common solar collector that you'll see in San Diego. It's a flat plate collector. And this is what will go on the roof, and this one collector will literally heat the water needs for about two people in a home. So there's plenty of space on your roof if you did want to install a solar electric system as well. And the way that the system works is, again, this is on the roof, and you'll see it's a dark surface that will be absorbing the heat from the sun, and it's covered with a glass plate. So sort of like your car on a hot day has the greenhouse effect. The heat is trapped inside. That's also how this collector works. So it traps the heat underneath the surface. And we can't see this, but underneath this surface are small copper pipes that contain water or heat transfer fluid.
Most systems cost between $5,000 and $10,000 to buy and install. Homeowners can expect about $1,500 in rebates and 30% in tax credits. The size of the rebates will shrink as the program nears its end date in 2017. For San Diego resident Jack Cooper, the price is worth it, even though the average return on investment is anywhere from 5 to 20 years.
I'm saving money every day I have it on, so eventually it's going to pay for itself.
So Jack, on a day like today, it's pretty overcast. Are you still saving money with the solar water heating system?
Yes, I am. But anytime the sun breaks through the cloud, today I'm running anywhere from 150 to 160 degree water.
Up to 40% of a home's energy use can go towards heating water for showers, dishes, and laundry. The California Center for Sustainable Energy ran a solar water heating pilot program for nearly 2.5 years. It ended in December.
We approved 407 applications. And so far, 263 of those projects have been complete and received a rebate.
Jim Backman of Adroit Solar, a company that specializes in high-end solar systems, is seeing interest pick up.
2009 has been a tough year in general in the residential construction economy, but a lot of people have been thinking about solar, been thinking hard about solar, and now the mass movement is really going in that direction.
He says that besides saving money, there are quality of life benefits as well.
You'll be improving local air quality, reducing your family's carbon footprint, and you can actually increase the capacity of hot water you have, so you'll have more hot water available, and you'll know that it was heated by the sun.
For more information on solar water heating, visit www.swh.energycenter.org. We want to know if you've installed a solar water heating system in your home. Tell us about it at kpbs.org/sdweek. For KPBS, I'm Sharon Heilbrunn.